Dimensions are used across a range of environments within SolidWorks, including sketching, features, mates, and 2D drawings. In this video, we'll take a look at some tips and tricks, as well as some of the less well-known functionality within dimensioning. Make sure to keep an eye on the SolidWorks environment icons, as these will identify which environment the specific tip can be used in. The Modify Dimension box that appears when adding or editing a dimension can be used in a number of useful ways to speed up the design process. When adding a dimension, the default unit system will be set, in this case it's millimeters. To quickly add in a dimension using a different unit system, such as inches, simply type in the required value and choose from the unit dropdown. The value will be then converted back to the default units. As well as picking from the unit dropdown list, unit symbols can also be typed. So for example, millimeter is mm, and inches could be input as either the inch symbol, which is the quotation mark, or in. This functionality is only relevant within sketching, features, and mates, and it would not be required within a 2D drawing. Linear dimensions can be added in a variety of different ways, such as selecting a single line, selecting a line and an endpoint, or selecting two endpoints. When selecting a single line or two endpoints, the projection of the dimension can be placed horizontally, vertically, or parallel to the selection. It's important to understand this, as if the dimension is added incorrectly, the length will not be as required. This is obvious when working across angles such as 45 degrees, but becomes less obvious when working with lower value angles. To help with this, the dimension projection can actually be locked before the dimension is placed, and this is done by clicking the right mouse button, indicated by the padlock icon. Once this has been locked, the dimension can then be positioned anywhere within the screen. When dimensioning between two circles or arcs, the default dimension that is added goes to the centre of each selection. To add the dimension so that it's anchored to either the minimum or maximum of the arc or circle, hold down Shift before making a selection, and then click the side in which the dimension should be anchored from. Shift should be held down for each selection, unless the centre point is required for one of the selections. Once placed, should the anchoring of the dimensions need to be modified, this can be controlled from the Leaders tab within the Dimension properties. Adding dimension to an arc to capture its radius value is really straightforward. But how about dimensioning the length of an arc? Well, to achieve this, select both endpoints and the arc itself. The resultant dimension will then follow the curvature of the arc, as well as showing the arc symbol above the dimension. When creating sketch geometry for revolved parts, a dimension can be added either as a radius or a diameter value. Selecting the sketch geometry and then a centreline allows the dimension to be placed as a radial value, or if the dimension is toggled across the centreline, the dimension will change to a diameter. You'll notice that no radius or diameter symbols exist initially, so if this is required, with the dimension selected, click the diameter button within the dimension properties. Once a dimension has been added in this way, if a diameter needs to be changed to a radius or vice versa, this can be toggled from the Leaders tab. It's common to need more than one dimension of this type, so once the first dimension has been added, the centreline selection is maintained, allowing more dimensions to be added quickly without the centreline being selected each time. Angle dimensions can easily be added by selecting two non-parallel lines, but angles can also be added between a line and an imaginary horizontal or vertical line too. When in the Smart Dimension tool, select the line or edge that the angle dimension needs to reference, and then select an endpoint. A crosshair appears, and a segment can be selected to define where the angle is defined from. When dimensions need to be added to a corner that no longer exists, a virtual shark can be added to dimension two. This can be achieved in a few different ways. To add a virtual shark in manually, control select two entities, and then click the point tool. This adds in a virtual sharp to the sketch that can then be dimensioned to. Virtual sharps can also be added as part of the dimensioning process. With the Smart Dimension tool already active, right-click on the first sketch line and choose Find Intersection, and then click on the second sketch line. The virtual sharp is added and the dimension attached to it, ready for the dimension's second selection. We've mentioned mouse gestures in a number of previous videos, as they are such an efficient way to access commands within SolidWorks, and the same goes for dimensioning. Using the default settings, holding down the right mouse button and dragging up will prompt the Smart Dimension tool in both the sketch and 2D drawing environment. Check out our video on customizing SolidWorks to increase productivity for more information on how to maximize what can be done with mouse gestures. Thanks for watching. Make sure to let us know if you have any ideas for other topics we can cover in future videos. And remember, if you're looking to create engaging 3D interactive presentations from your CAD, be sure to check out Cadasio. Create a free account at cadasio.com.